Has anyone ever heard of Poetry Slam before? Slam poetry? Yeah, put your hands up if you have. Yeah, a few of you. Whoa, heaps of you. Well, for those of you who haven't, it was started by a guy in Chicago. He was going to these poetry readings and he would stand up there and be like, the cat sat on the mat and it was fat. And he's like, that's it. We're going to put a time limit on it. We're going to make it energetic. The point is to entertain the crowd, to engage the crowd, and you're going to be randomly judged by members of the audience. So I'm from Bankstown Poetry Slam. It's the largest poetry, regular poetry slam in the country. If you like what you see here, there's going to be three awesome poets. I'm going to do two short poems for you right now. Like I said, it is randomly judged by members of the audience, but this poem I didn't care about the points. I wrote it for my grandparents who came to Australia and they had to change their names. And I never really understood why, because if they can pronounce Shakespeare, if they can pronounce Dostoevsky, Alighieri, Kafka, Tolkien and Baudelaire, they can pronounce your name. If they can pronounce Mozart, Tchaikovsky, Beethoven and Bach, Picasso, Da Vinci, Michelangelo and Van Gogh, Aristotle, Einstein, Galileo and Freud. If they can pronounce Monet while sipping Moe, quote Plato while eating paleo, read Latin while watching Aladdin while eating Greek salad and wearing a kaftan. If they can eat a burrito in a kimono, dance the Indy with a bindi, order foie gras with a side of quinoa, then jump in their Toyota and drive to Woolahra. Don't want to be late for yoga. If they can learn to make cappuccinos in a shop, they can learn to write some letters on a cup. If they can fly to piss through our continents, they can try to hiss through our consonants. If they can wrap their tongue around my kebab, they can wrap their tongue around my vocab. For I'm not your lunch order that you can point at and stumble through, nor am I your fashion item that you have appropriated to. This label that was given to me and you is wrapped in history, so get to know yours too. Because if they can pronounce Joffrey, if they can pronounce Arya, Tyrion, Sansa and Daenerys, Hagrid, Hermione, Dumbledore and Voldemort, if they can pronounce Macbeth, Hamlet, Romeo, Othello, art thou thee, doth hither, sither, thither, if they can pronounce Shakespeare, then they can pronounce your name. Thank you. So I heard some of you in the audience say you were clicking. I like that. Can everyone do that? So clicking in Poetry Slam, if you like something, you give them a click. You can stomp your feet. You can give it a yas if you're really into it. You can be loud as you want. Do it. I want to feel that. I'm going to do one last poem, and you're going to test that clicking now. I want you to click if you like it. If you don't, that's cool. You can boo. I don't mind. But then for the next poets, I really want you to keep that clicking going. So practice it for me now. I grew up watching YouTube a lot. I never really watched TV. And I found that I connected a lot more with the people that I saw on YouTube, with a lot of the bloggers, and kind of finding my identity. And I still kind of do that a lot. It's weird that people so far away you connect with kind of more with. But anyway, this was kind of inspired by some of the bloggers and stuff that I used to watch. And yeah, I don't know. Dear 16-year-old me, don't pop that pimple. Dear 16-year-old me, stop chasing that guy. No, seriously, don't pop that pimple. It really does leave scars. Dear 16-year-old me, stop chasing that other guy. He may have a six-pack, be into cool music now, but he ends up obsessed with six-packs and obsessed with really bad dubstep. Dear 16-year-old me, don't worry about what really bad dubstep is. Right now, just keep vibing to the strings and snares that make you happy. Ramones, Led Zeppelin, they laugh at you now, but they'll be buying their shirts in JJ soon. Dear 16-year-old me, your teachers are humans too. Be nice to them. You want to be one day. On that note, stop hating poetry. You'll start performing it in time. No, keep hating poetry. so you'll be inspired to spit fire and bring tired poetry alive. Dear 16-year-old me, unlearn your curriculum. There's more to life than the colonial stories outsold, more histories of heroes untold. Dear 16-year-old me, learn your history. Take pride in the roots that raise your roses. Learn the language that laughs on the lips of your grandparents. Dear 16-year-old me, visit your grandparents. Savor every spoonful of your nene's pilaf like it's your last. Little do you know, it will soon be your last. Ask questions about their life. And maybe this poem wouldn't be so long. Dear 16-year-old me, it's okay to read Harry Potter again. For right now, it's magic is the realest thing you know. Dear 16-year-old me, real will come in a way you have no idea now. Real friends, real aspirations, real love, by God, real love will come barging through the door. Welcome it. The doorbell is already ringing. Dear 16-year-old me, answer the door. Let yourself in. The real you is waiting to be loved. Dear 16-year-old me, stop worrying, stop stopping, stop listening to people who tell you what to do, especially if they claim to be a wiser version of your older self. Dear 16-year-old me, keep dreaming, keep keeping, keep questioning. I know it's not so hard, it seems so hard, but I assure you it isn't simple. It is simple, but I assure you right now the only thing you need to do is to please don't pop that pimple. Thank you. And keep that round of applause going. Keep the clicks going for Ada.
Hi guys. This poem was kind of written out of a place of frustration, which I feel like is an emotion that this generation feels a lot. And I also think that we have the right to it. So anyway, I'm just going to jump right into it. You have labeled us the me, me, me generation. And you talk of the world's demise since our birth. You call us entitled, selfish, lazy, slaves to technology, yet complain that we are out of control. And this is where your true fears manifest. See, this is a resistance you cannot counter, though your propaganda attempts to regulate us, says beauty is the only thing that can validate us, but embracing physicality only sexualizes us. It seems we have no choice but to let you criticize us. Self-hatred is a convenient method of control, but we took the nooses you tied for us, made internet sensations of them, fashion them into bracelets, into bridges. See, your aging ears have misheard the chanting, for it is not a call of me, 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 but rather that of we, we, we. We are sick of being blamed for your generation's mistakes. We are tired of a government that pretends we don't matter. We are fed up with people trying to regulate our bodies. We are angry that racism is alive and kicking. We are members of a community that transcends these borders you fight so hard to protect. You see, differences are not threats, are not barriers. We understand basic rights, value humanity and culture, the opening of communication channels, the sharing of knowledge. So when I scoff at the phrase stop the boats, it is not due to lack of understanding. When I mention LGBTQIA and have to explain the acronym, it is not me who is uninformed. When identifying as a feminist or a Muslim is met with disgust and death threats, it is not a reflection of who I am, but of this society you have created. And it speaks ill of the human race that our voices are smudged by others' fingerprints around our throats. But we have grown up making light of the darkness, learning to live with it, but not become it. the Harry Potter to your Lord Voldemort. See, while you've been squinting at that screen trying to control Z your mistakes, we've been embracing failure, learning to make the best of it. We've been Snapchatting the experience and making jokes of it. See, you called us the me, me, me generation. But I think you meant meme, meme, meme. Thanks, guys. Keep that applause going for Bilal.
This poem is titled "The Strongest Man in the World." Me? I'm not a strong man. Nah. I met the strongest man in the world when I was 8 years old. He lifted me on his arm. And when I asked him how he did it, he said it was easy. That I hardly weighed a thing at all. That how could I have made him sore when he was so big? And I stood near him and looked so small. See, me? I'm not a strong man. No. I met the strongest man in the world when I was less than a minute old, and he didn't hold me then. Didn't parade in the long line of men in my life who would tell me when my wife showed me attitude that it was because of my failing as a husband. Those marching men, flailing and stunted, frightened, that having softened hearts would mean having a softened chest. But the strongest man in the world, he taught me best. Taught me ignore the rest and bore the zest out of life with your wife and take a carving knife to the modern model, manly man. See me, I'm not a strong man. No. I met the strongest man in the world when I was less than a minute old and he didn't hold me then. But he held my mum when she held me and just us three felt lucky as could be. When I asked him later how he did it, he said it was easy. That we hardly weighed a thing at all. My father is not really a tall man, but he could draw you a floor plan to the house he'd build his children. He knows it like the back of his hand, knows each room and where he would build them. He'd say, here, I'd put the sunroom for you kids to play, and if I could, I'd pull the sun and moon down every day so you could all say, look how strong my dad is. My father is the kindest man in the world. He would say, here, I'd put the kitchen, and I'd build all the cupboards at waist height because you were all raised right, but at a raised height, I think your mum might have a hard time reaching. But I'd build her that kitchen so you could all never forget to mention, look how strong my dad is. My father is the gentlest man in the world. He'd say, here, I'd put the garden, and I could sit and watch from the yard when your mum's green thumb makes me numb, makes everyone else's green thumb seem dumb. I'd build her a garden and I'd sit there guarding every little thing she grew because she went and grew each and every one of you. My father is the strongest man in the world. And for me, strength is the hardest word in the world to define, because you look it up and there you'll find the quality or state of being physically strong. I met the strongest man in the world today. I asked him how his morning was, and he said that the cold makes his bones ache, but he never moans awake when he goes to take my little sister to school. So when she gets there, she can say, I met the strongest man in the world today. But what she'll really say is, I met the kindest man in the world today. I met the gentlest man in the world today. I met the most respectful man in the world today. I got dropped off by my dad today. Thank you. Thank you guys very much for paying attention to our poetry. Now, please, can you get that round of applause started up again for one of the most amazing independent artists I've ever had the pleasure of meeting, Christy Steve and Kyra.
How's everybody feeling? Oh, come on. How you guys feeling? That's it. All right, cool. My name is Christy Steve, and this is a very beautiful Kyra beside me, who's also an independent artist. And we're going to do a couple of covers. for you today. So if you feel like singing along, please do. This one's called Treasure. Enjoy. Can you guys follow me? Come on. Yeah.
Give me your attention, baby. I gotta tell you a little something about yourself. You're wonderful, flawless, ooh, you're a sexy lady. But you walk around here like you wanna be someone else. Oh, oh, girl, I'm gonna show you that you're fine, so fine. Oh, oh, girl, I'm gonna show you when you're mine. Cause a girl like you should never look so blue. You're everything that I see in my dreams. Wouldn't tell that to you if it wasn't true, no. Oh, oh, oh. Girl, I'm gonna show you that you're fine, so fine. Oh, oh, oh. Girl, I'm gonna show you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I thought that song was quite appropriate for today. So this next song is called Crazy, and I kind of like to do this song a little bit slow and kind of make you listen to the lyrics a little bit. So yeah, enjoy this one.
I remember when I lost my mind. There was something so pleasant about that place. Even your emotions had an echo so much space. When you're out there without a care, yeah, it was out of touch. And it wasn't because I didn't know enough. I just knew too much. Does that make me crazy? Does that make me crazy? Does that make me crazy? Probably. Oh. Well, I hope that you are having the time of your life. Yeah, yes. Think twice. That's my only advice. Go come on now, who do you, who do you, who do you, who do you think you are? But ha ha ha, bless your soul. You're out of control. Ever since I was little, it looked like fun. And it's no coincidence, of course, I can die when I'm done. Does that make me crazy? Does that make me
Thank you so much. Thank you. Do I have time for one more? Do we? All right, this is one of my favorite songs to sing. This also involves you, and it just, all you have to sing is yeah, 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 and I'll cue you when. All right, here we go.
And my life is still trying to get up that great big hill of hope for a destination.
You feel me?
I realized quickly when I knew I should have the whole world made of this brotherhood of men for whatever that means. And so I cry sometimes when lying in bed just to get it all out what's in my head. And I'm feeling a little peculiar. I wake up in the morning and I step outside and I take a deep, get real high, and I, the top of my lungs, what's going on? You know the words. And I said, yeah. Yell it out.
Come on.
I said, hey, 5 years and my life is still trying to get off that great big hill of hope for a destination.
Thank you so much. Please give it up for Kyra on guitar. My name is Christy Steve, and I'm going to hand it over to these guys. Thank you so much. Here's Mira.
Greetings, everybody. How y'all feeling? I'm just going to go into it. Check, check, check. Kingdoms are known above our earth skies. Land of Canaan, some blessed with their lives. Hands bounded, all palms by one side. Bow to supreme whom you ever recognize. Don't misjudge nor take advantage, analyze. Elements, belief, keep up a middle eyes. Some ojos may be closed of a God one adores. Hindu, Allah, Judah, Buddha, Tao, our Lord. Exceed to read and learn, learn, let your minds observe. Preserve all many scripts, sacred scriptures. Study your forms for mind to discern. Disasters do strike when minds do defer. What I won with these wars when peace should occur. Come along, be no more, let's all engender. Conclusion of thought, earth's a concern. Conditions we live towards our future. So make sure you keep continuing this positivity and communication. I'm Indonesian and African American, and I work with Elfresh the Lion. If you don't know, beautiful man, Indian who represents hip-hop and a great foundations of music. And we have a song called Hold Up, and I just wanted to share quickly the verse because I find there's so many different peoples that look at me, like everybody that you mixed, beautifully mixed in here, and they assume that you're just what you present. And I'm like, no, I'm mixed. So it says, okay, I gotta share what happens to me. I either get a blank stare when I'm on stage. They act too cool to enjoy what's plain. Then they step to me and this is what they say. You really are Australian, your accent is fake. You're really not black and are you straight or gay? But I really like your raps and your voice is great. Then takes a photo, not even asking me. Okay, this really happens when I wear my raps. I get, oh wow, I love your colorful hat. Now can I touch it? And can you teach me that? But the hands all on it with a pat, pat, pat. Oh, now you got me going down memory lane. There was this one time I shook my head in shame. My hair done did cornrow with braids. She done messed it up with her damn ring. Hands all in it to feel the texture. Ring got caught, so messed up my hair. Looked at me embarrassed with ups and oh dear. And I'ma watch how you fix it style. Mine's like that there.
So this song that I'm talking about now, about being different and how beautiful it is, unfortunately, there's racism, there's hatred. And when we look at social media, every time if I'm on Facebook or YouTube, why do I always see violence? And the first verse is basically talking about what's really important to me, being that I'm mixed culture, but just a human that loves humanity. Why are people of color or face being killed? You know, and there's brutality. And I'm not just saying about government. There's brutality against one another, you know, bullying, trolls. And then it stems to the bigger world, which is war. And so my question was, and I think your question would be as well, we want to know. Where did hate come from?
Turn it up, please, if possible.
Tyrant comes, blade of tongues, misinterpretation, harm does flood, miscommunication, where does it come from? Discrimination.
We wanna know how it came about.
Good question.
We wanna know, we wanna know. Will it drown us or become a drought? We just don't know. We wanna know how it came about.
to apply. Praying every child on the block won't die. Talk on their back like they under attack. Got the iPhone 5 so the cops don't lie. Fighting for the country with the street got war. Every brother in school, prison got four. Why do you think we out here selling out tours? Working with the world trying to settle that score. I can't take it no more. Freedom is torn, more devil is born. On another level, Lord, leave a less born. Dust starts to settle when the evil is born. Bird's eye view when the cross the Jones. Media hype increases hate to discriminate.
We want to know how it came about.
We want to know.
How many people are you think of this question?
When the drowners will become a drought. We just don't know.
I think we only have a short amount of time, and this song's really important. It's called Little Vicky, and it's basically dedicated to all women, and even young people, or people that are transgender fluid, and you feel that you've been portrayed wrongly, and you become a little victim in society. So we'll just go right in.
Fangirl.
Hey.
Love you.
Every day I want you to know that you're a beautiful person. From all your flaws, it's not a flaw, it's called a challenge, and you're learning to become better. A mistake is never a mistake. It's about learning to become a beautiful butterfly and the blossom to become a better human. Sometimes I think this figure was me when I was little. You were that lost soul and that individual, or you might feel this now. This is a beautiful reminder that you are beautiful.
She was once a little girl, an ugly duckling, wanted to be loved. And at school she was upset, 'cause the boys would only attention to her.
She didn't exist.
No class and sessions during weekdays. No grade obsessions, trick or treats. Little Vicky, only 16. Sharing no secrets, wearing
There's a lot of women out there. Don't prejudge them, okay? There's so much history and baggage in us. Like I said before, that baggage can be unpacked and filled with many other goodies.
She just yearns to be the center of all life, not to be restricted in all lies. She just wants to not be hated, talked to and related. So respect her like a beautiful girl. She was casted out like wastage, was intimidated by those who were beautiful girls. She just wants to not be hated, talked to and related, so respect her like a beautiful girl. Just a beautiful girl. To all the little Vickies worldwide.
Just a beautiful girl.
From a little girl to a young lady to a woman.
Just a beautiful girl.
We can face negative challenges. Like discrimination through sexism. Feeling insecure because our mass media promotes unrealistic body shapes. And at worst, sexual harassment and abuse. Little Vicky can't show you always that you are a young lady and a beautiful woman too. So acknowledge your life value. And may you know you are a beautiful girl again. And may that day arise that you resonate and empower that beautiful attitude within. So please remember as a community inside here today to resonate that positive attitude so other people can feel empowered. It's about teamwork. It does make another dream's work.
We ain't worried about it. That's another day.
Where my ladies at? This one for the girls who have lost their moms. And this is for the moms who have lost their jobs. It's time to recognize who you can become. Strong woman with the aim of goals, so hold on. This is one for the girls who have learned to be a superheroine. Yearn, succeed. I salute you for your faith, believe. Now you can run the world like knows. Succeed, you a star. Don't come back, get involved. Be the best that you can, be the boss in control. Be a student and a teacher yelling out. Roll call, say your name, who you are. What your aim, what your goal, shine bright through the tunnel, which is dark and deep. Thinking girl, you are earth, you are yin, you are eve. I am woman, you a woman, you reflect as a queen. Time to rise up and now scream! So we may not worry about it right now, but every day it's a worry upon someone else's mind. So make sure you take it involved. Enjoy the rest of the day. Thank you for having me. It means the world. Y'all.